guys, I'm Kate and I'll be telling you the story today. So God loves us so much that he sent Jesus to die for us. Jesus paid the sins for those who were before him and for the people that came after him. So for the people that weren't even born yet, like you and me. So for everyone who puts their trust in Jesus, there's no sin left to punish. Jesus paid it all. Now I'm going to tell you a story to help explain this. So one day, the Gambrel family went out and the father decided to treat his six kids to some ice cream. So they went to the gelato store and Jack, the eldest, decided to get some watermelon ice cream. And he was so excited for it that he just started eating it straight away before his dad paid for it. But the shop owner didn't seem to mind. And then his sister, Beck, decided to get some double choc ice cream. Sounds good, doesn't it? She also started eating it, and by this point, Jack was halfway through his ice cream, but no one had paid for the ice cream yet. But the shop owner didn't seem to mind at all. Then, the three sisters, Sophie, Emily, and Anna, all decided to get bubblegum ice cream. By this point, Jack had finished his ice cream, Beck was halfway through her ice cream, and still no one had paid for the ice cream. But the shop owner still didn't seem to mind. Everything seemed fine. And then it was little Eric's turn. He decided that he also was going to get double chocolate ice cream. But before he chose, his dad paid for it. But it didn't matter, because you see, the dad, he paid for the ice cream that had already been eaten, that was still being eaten by the three sisters, and that was going to be eaten by little Eric. It didn't seem to matter. The shop owner knew that the dad was going to pay for all of them eventually. So this is like us and Jesus. Jesus paid the sin for us once and for all. He didn't have to do it for the people when they were in the past. He didn't have to do it for us now. He doesn't have to do it for us in the future. He paid for it once and for all. If you've asked Jesus to pay for your sins, then all of your sins have been paid in full. The sin you've already done, the sin that you did today, the sin that you'll do tomorrow, Jesus has already paid for all of it in full. No sin can ever separate you and Jesus.
Hi Beagles, I'm Esther and we're going to play an elimination game. So how this is going to work is I'm going to say something and if it's true of you, then you're out of the game. For example, if I said, you're out if you're wearing a red shirt. And if you're wearing a red shirt, that means you're out. So that was a practice and we're going to do actual game now. So you're out if you ate oatmeal or porridge for breakfast. You're out if your name starts with the letter L or C. You're out if you're wearing a watch. You're out if you walk to school every day. You're out if you have a dog as a pet. You're out if your favorite color is blue. Or you're out if you have a younger sister. Did you get out or did you stay in? Well, unlike this game, nothing can separate us from God. In fact, Romans 8 tells us that nothing in all creation can separate us from God's love. And that's a really great truth to hold on to. So thanks for playing Beagles.
Hi guys, I'm Harrison. I'm going to be praying with us today, so could you guys repeat after me? Father God, thank you for loving us so much. You have separated us from our sin, and now nothing can separate us from your love. Amen. Awesome. So if you guys, for our individual prayer at home, if you guys could pray thinking over this term, and pray about something you've learned. So some examples is last week, we learned about how the Holy Spirit can help us talk to God. And this week, we learned about how nothing can separate us from God's love. So you can pray for that or something else you've learned. Thanks, guys.
So from today's talk, we learned that if you say yes to Jesus, then God loves you. And now sin can no longer separate us from God's love. And to help us remember that for today's craft, we're going to be making a paper chain out of these words. Nothing can separate us from God's love. So I want you guys to cut out each strand to make a loop and chain them together. And it'll look a little bit like this. So this is my finished craft, and it says nothing can separate us from God's love in a nice little chain. Oh my goodness, this chain got massive! Oh, I think you guys can make it even bigger though, and you see if you guys can make a chain that's even longer, which will remind you that nothing can separate us from God's love.
Here are your crafts from last week. And here's the craft you can do at home this week. We'll see you next time.